Elon Musk just found the perfect combination for a semi-solid lithium battery. Elon Musk, CEO of Tesla, has committed to making significant improvements to the way Tesla makes the batteries that power its energy station systems and electric autos. However, he is not alone in this quest. Large competitors such as General Motors, China's BYD and CATL, and an idealistic Norwegian upstart called Freyr all have their sights set on developing the game-changing battery technology. However, Elon might have gotten there first. So what's new about this battery, and how will it be a game-changer? Are semi-solid-state batteries going to be the next big thing in the energy transition? Well, Elon Musk recently made it clear that this technology has the potential to increase the driving range of electric cars, make rapid charging possible, and make vehicles safer. Even though solid-state technology has maintained its high potential for over a decade, there are few indications that it will succeed significantly in the coming years. Now, an innovative hybrid technology known as semi-solid batteries has the potential to render solid-state batteries technology outdated before it even gets a chance to get off the ground. What exactly is meant by the term semi-solid lithium-ion battery? A semi-solid battery is a battery that includes solid battery active parts and a liquid battery portion. It is fascinating that the Tesla research team utilized lithium-ion battery materials in this idea. The negative electrode, also known as the anode, and the positive electrode, also known as the cathode in this battery, are constructed out of carbon black and active material particles suspended in a liquid electrolyte. The research team at Tesla has made a significant advancement toward its goal of producing semi-solid lithium-ion battery cells that have an energy density of more than 350 watt-hours per kilogram. Instead of injecting the electrolyte into a slurry, this method is considered more effective for making cells, where the active components of the electrolytes are combined prior to the production of the cell. This method is known as the integration method. In contrast to other technologies, in which a solvent is used to kind of deposit stuff before throwing it all up and then injecting the electrolyte at the end of the process, Tesla incorporated it right from the start. The integration makes it possible for the ions and the electrolytes to move freely through the battery. Probably before the end of 2023, we will see Tesla present its first prototype production line to the public. Drawbacks of solid-state lithium-ion batteries. Solid-state lithium-ion batteries provide several benefits but have many technical drawbacks. But despite these drawbacks, utilizing all solid-state lithium-ion batteries is still recommended. On one hand, solid-state batteries do not use liquid electrolytes. Consequently, this significantly reduces the battery's ionic conductivity, making it challenging to accomplish rapid charging. On the other hand, the internal resistance of the solid electrolyte contact, also known as solid-solid resistance, is quite high, and because of the battery's increased internal resistance, it loses more energy, which causes it to produce more heat. If the battery does not adequately cool down, there is also the possibility of it catching fire. Tesla's greatest problem has been its battery's charging time and reduced performance during the cold months. The semi-solid batteries use the solid electrolyte, and the fact that the electrolyte is in solid form means that the low temperature will not negatively impact the battery's performance. This provides an efficient solution to the issue of reduced battery life for all electric vehicles during the cold months. Also, the problems associated with low contact surfaces and sluggish production procedures can be circumvented by utilizing components of both solid and liquid electrolytes in the battery. But semi-solid is no golden goose. Adding the liquid electrolyte causes the cell to have a greater volume and weight, even though it is an upgrade over the current cells. Even if the technical issues are resolved, the production costs still need to be brought down before large-scale production can begin. At the moment, the cost of raw materials for solid-state lithium-ion batteries is 5 times more than the cost of raw materials for conventional lithium-ion batteries. In addition, the manufacturing of solid-state lithium-ion batteries calls for a high purity of the raw materials, which results in a considerable investment in the necessary equipment. Advantages of semi-solid-state lithium-ion batteries. It is common knowledge that the maximum capacity of traditional lithium-ion batteries is 300 watt-hours a kilogram. In contrast, the capacity of first-generation semi-solid-state lithium-ion batteries might reach up to 400 watt-hours a kilogram. When it comes to autos, the primary considerations that go into buyers' and manufacturers' decisions are cost and level of safety. Therefore, this will be the go-to option if semi-solid-state batteries are safer. According to research, the semi-solid battery is cycled 2,000 times at room temperature and maintains more than 85% of its original capacity after each cycle. The typical rechargeable liquid battery is cycled 1,200 times under the same circumstances, but only around 80% of its capacity is retained during the process. Competition and challenges that Tesla is facing. Now, Elon Musk is facing a lot of competition since, in 2021, Kyocera made history by becoming the first business in the world to mass-produce so-called semi-solid batteries. This firm, situated in Kyoto, can create 200 megawatt-hours annually, which is equivalent to the capacity of 20,000 household energy storage devices. The production is currently operating at somewhere close to half its capability. According to Hidemichi Tonari, who works for Kyocera's energy solutions company, there is 40% less carbon dioxide produced in the manufacturing process. The lifespan is also significantly greater than that of standard batteries. However, the capacity of Kyocera's batteries is just 140 watt-hours per kilogram, around 60% of what lithium-ion batteries typically offer. Compared to what Elon Musk is promising to offer, Tesla is aiming its sights on 400 watt-hours a kilogram, which is quite reasonable. However, Kyocera is contemplating beginning mass production of these batteries in a larger capacity as early as 2025. The need for batteries that are less harmful to the environment is a significant element that is pushing the development of semi-solid batteries for mass manufacture. The European Union will mandate that firms declare their greenhouse gas emissions beginning in 2024, including during production and disposal. The European Union plans to restrict the market entry of high-emission batteries in the year 2027. To put it another way, there will be a decrease in demand for high-capacity batteries that have a huge carbon footprint. The United States and Japan are moving in the same general direction. This technology may be confronted with obstacles in the near future. Its energy performance is improved due to the utilization of a lithium metal anode, which substitutes the cumbersome and charge-limiting graphite. However, this places additional pressure on a market that is already becoming more competitive. Lithium metal foils are high-performance materials that must adhere to demanding purity requirements. This is why the global production capacity is only 12.8 kt LCE at the moment, which is less than a sixth of the required capacity. In the end, the development of this technology may be hampered by the increasingly apparent signals of an inadequate supply of lithium to the market or by a lack of infrastructure in the manufacturing of specialized lithium anode materials. Testing of semi-solid batteries. Researchers from Tesla have put semi-solid batteries through their paces to evaluate their safety performance. Extreme overcharge tests, short circuit tests, and extreme heating tests were carried out on the batteries in accordance with the appropriate requirements. During the extreme overcharge test, the semi-solid battery deflated after experiencing some swelling and being overcharged. During the test of excessive heating, the battery was put through the test. It had an over-temperature capability that was far higher than the 130 degrees Celsius stipulated in the standard solid-state battery, indicating a high safety level. Traditional batteries have significant safety hazards since their electrolytes are highly flammable. Due to their limited thermal stability and low flame points, these electrolytes have the potential to easily cause fire mishaps and explosions if they are not utilized properly. Even though Tesla has significantly improved the range over the past few years, the new battery will only significantly expand the impressive driving range. Already, the Tesla Model S can travel anywhere from 390 to 412 miles on a single charge, depending on the version of the vehicle you purchase. The new semi-solid-state battery is supposed to give a 54% improvement over the previous battery. This already equates to competing on an even playing field with solid-state batteries, and by the end of the year, Tesla may have developed a more effective battery, more environmentally friendly, and higher energy storage density. While everyone is working feverishly to develop a battery that is not only powerful, but also long-lasting, efficient, and effective, the first one to pop out doesn't necessarily mean it has won the race. because of its early embrace of lithium-ion battery technology and years of research into developing batteries for electric vehicles, Tesla maintains a competitive advantage over its rivals because it is obvious that semi-solid-state batteries will be the next big thing. That's all from this video. What do you think about this technology? See you in the next one.